Good morning. This day, it's a day the Lord has made. This past week is a week the Lord has made. The fact that Wednesday morning arrived is a day the Lord has made. Our nation is picking up the pieces. We're moving into an unknown future. And that's true with all of us, including myself, including every one of us. We don't know what this afternoon's going to bring. We don't know what January's going to bring. We don't know what the future's going to bring. But we do know it's a day the Lord has made. We rejoice and are glad in it. I do welcome you to worship on this Sunday morning, whether you're joining us in our beautiful sanctuary or several opportunities through our broadcast ministries. This time, I'd ask you to please stand and join in singing one of my favorite hymns, "When the Storms of Life Are Raging, Stand By Me." Please stand and sing with me. Please be seated. When AsbSrv was built a little over 100 years ago, we were not thinking about showing video during worship, obviously. This morning's video, the first one Bob is going to show, I'd prefer it being showed in about 10 minutes, but because of the technology aspect of moving the screen back and forth, we're going to show first of all the Veterans Appreciation, then followed by the Seed Time. So Bob, we'll start with Veterans, whenever you're ready. We'll go right from one to the other.
This morning is, of course, Wall Street, as the markets have been hammered since the opening bell. After a brief bounce, things are continuing to head south, leaving many wondering where the bottom will be.
Alan, today is not the day to have trouble getting hold of you. Please give me a call back as soon as you get this.
Hey, how you feeling?
Hungry.
Well, that's a good thing, right? I think so. I'm gonna get something in a little bit. Where are you going?
Ray's asked me to go down to the soup kitchen for a little bit to help out, and then I have got to run by the office and take care of some business.
You and the kids have been down there quite a bit lately, haven't you?
Look, no one's gonna blame you if you don't want to go back.
No, I think it's great. I'm looking forward to seeing everyone again.
Love you.
Love you.
Hey, remind me that I need to discuss some things with you when I get back, all right?
Sure.
Stock market killing you today.
Oh, yeah, man. My 4167K is taking a beating.
I know that's true.
Mrs. Donovan.
Hey, sorry I'm late, Ray. What's all this?
It's a beautiful day, Mrs. Donovan. Can you feel the sunlight just streaming in?
You mean the sunlight coming through those holes in the ceiling?
But not for long. Those grants we applied for came through. This place is getting new life.
Oh, that is excellent news, Ray. You guys deserve this.
That's not even the best part. Those men there are from Somerset Construction. I don't know if they're getting some kind of matching dollars or what, but they're looking to hire as many folk from the kitchen as possible for the labor, even off in training for certain positions.
Oh, well, let me know if they have room for a volunteer. I got a hammer. At least I think I got a hammer.
That market stuff that everybody's talking about, how's that affecting you?
Ray, I'm sorry, I gotta take this, it's urgent. Alan, hey. Yeah, it's urgent. Okay, can you come by the house a little bit later? Perfect. Talk to you then.
The general consensus seems to be relief that the day is over. The fear now is that the Asian markets will respond too strongly to today's sell-off, which could trigger a...
Hey.
Hey. By the way, I've called Alan to come over here for a meeting. He's going to come over a little bit later. There's some things that I wanted to go over with you first. Make sure we're on the same page.
Okay.
Your accident made a big impact on me. I remember sitting there just staring at you, waiting for you to recover. I was powerless. I remember thinking to myself, everything that I tried to do to protect this family, everything. And you know what? It just felt silly. Ray mentioned something the other day. We were talking about the parable of the talents and how out of all the three servants who were asked to look over their master's money, the only one who was rebuked was the one who had buried the money and then returned it the same way he received it. The one that played it safe. I want to take risks. If God owns everything and we're willing to risk it all for him and it doesn't work out, well, it's just like moving money from one of his pockets to the other. It might mean a lot of changes, and that's why I have Alan coming over. So what do you think?
I think Ray's the best gardener we've ever had. So how does all this market stuff going on affect what you've been thinking?
What market stuff? Hey, Ray.
Hi, Ms. Donovan. How you doing?
Good.
I just came by to reseed a couple of patches in the yard, and I wanted to give you a little present, in case you couldn't find yours.
Wow, this is a beauty. You swing that in, right?
Right.
How are things going down there?
You know, right after you left this morning, we got a call, said that there were holes in the grant application, and they wouldn't even review it until we corrected it.
Government.
Yeah, right. I was just trying to figure out how Somerset Construction could already be on site and they haven't even reviewed the grant application.
I don't know. I guess you'll have to ask them.
Well, that's the thing. I did. No one over there seemed to know anything about any grants.
Strange. Hey, I got a family meeting, so I got to run to.
Yeah, right. One thing I want to ask. Doesn't your company own Somerset?
Gosh, Ray, got so much stuff on the plate right now, and I really don't want to talk business.
Yeah, I understand.
Thanks for the hammer, Ray.
You're welcome, Mr. Donovan.
Sorry about that, Alan. You were saying?
So,
I know how important security is to you, so I've prepared some ideas to fortify your portfolio in light of today's events.
Maybe I wasn't that clear with you earlier today, Alan. We actually had some of our own ideas, as a family.
Okay, sure.
Our goal is to increase liquidity across all areas. We want to start by dismantling our...
Intentionally.
Defective.
Grandma Trust.
We'd like to have that charity discussion you suggested the other day.
So what do you think? Can you help us out?
Stand and join me now as we share together our call to worship and time of greeting. Day by day, an abundance of God's love. Morning by morning, new signs of blessing. We are surrounded by God's blessings. I greet you in the name of Christ. Let us now greet one another.
Please join me in the opening thoughts printed in your bulletin. God of truth, we come longing for the peace that only you can provide. We seem so often to be tossed to and fro, blown about by every wind except that of your own Holy Spirit. Be pleased to dwell here this day, to receive our worship and our praise. Linger long and speak the truth to us in love, that we may come to the unity of faith and to the knowledge of the full stature of Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. Let us now affirm our beliefs. We believe that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth and gave to us every plant yielding seed that is on the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit, so that we have them for food. We believe that we are to take some of the first of all the fruit of the ground, which we harvest from the land that the Lord God has given us, and are to put it in a basket and go to the place that the Lord our God has chosen as a dwelling for his name. We believe that if we honor the Lord with our substance and with the first fruits of all our produce, then our barns will be filled with plenty and our vats will be bursting with wine. This we believe.
God has set between us and those who wish us harm some peacemakers, some peacekeepers. And sometimes they are common, ordinary folk who work with other individuals to find reconciliation. As I look at the events of this past week, I'm so grateful for the reconciliation steps that I've seen in President-elect Trump, in Hillary Clinton, and in President Obama, as they have showed us about moving forward, about being peacemakers and peacekeepers. Let us pray. Lord, we know that sometimes our peacemakers and peacekeepers wear uniforms. Sometimes they stand between us and the terrorists who wish us harm. Sometimes they are thousands of miles away on the battlefield. We also know that sometimes peacemakers and peacekeepers are here at home, serving us locally. Other times they serve in our nation's capital as they try and show us your will and your way for our world. So, Lord, teach us. Teach us the path you have chosen for us this day. We lift up and give you thanks for the peacemakers, the ones that Jesus called blessed, the ones who he called your children. Bless your children this day. Through Christ we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
way of all the those who have recently or who are currently serving the armed forces to please stand. And could I have those who have served in the past to please stand? Thank you. On Friday, I was looking through some of my dad's military pictures at a time, obviously, way before I knew him. And my mom would share some stories about my dad back at that time. Some of those comments are not appropriate for church. I spent a few years with Dad, several decades, in fact. But as I looked at those pictures on Friday, I realized, and maybe it's my maturity, I'd like to think so anyways, as I realized, so much of who I am today was because of my dad. And how it wasn't always things that he said, but the way he just lived life. The way he helped to mold and shape me to become who I am today. And I look around at our veterans, those who have served, those who are currently serving, and those who are shaping the generation today, as well as the generations to come. As our video this morning expressed, we salute you and we thank you. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we know today there are many husbands and wives and children and grandchildren, fathers and mothers serving as our deployed troops around the world. We know that many of our veterans have traveled to places far from home. We know that many of our veterans and those serving have served close to home, protecting our freedoms. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for the ways that they have shaped us and molded us as a nation, as a people, but also as individuals. For their sacrifices, for their many sacrifices, we say thank you. We offer this prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you again. This past week, we had one of our more seasoned members, died, Evelyn Lennon, and was doing some research regarding a membership database. Kay, would you stand, please? You probably don't remember this, but October was a special month for you. Do you remember something happened back October? No? Close.
Okay. Joining the church.
Yes. The month of October, 72 years ago.
That makes me.
61. Congratulations on your 72nd anniversary for being a member of AsbSrv. And a couple of newer, younger members, Mary Ann Scott, Dale Scott, and Barbara Sargent. This month, you celebrate your 45th anniversary. Barb, Mary Ann, Dale, congratulations. Now I'll get back to the program because you can't tell the players out of program here. I invite you at this time to find your sign-in pads and pass them around this morning. If this is your first Sunday to worship at AsbSrv, please stop at the Welcome Center after worship as we have a gift for you. If you have a joy or concern you'd like lifted up in prayer, you'll find some pink sheets there in your seats. Just fill them out, and during the children's time, which will be coming up soon, you can hand it to an usher who will make sure I have it. Lynn, are we all set?
Sure. Part of thinking positive.
It is. When the saints go marching in. Will the children please come on down for a story? Good morning. I'm glad you're all here today. The Bible tells us, well, let me ask this question. How many of you have ever spent an afternoon counting the number of hairs on your head? Strange, isn't it? How about, oh, I know, maybe counting the hairs of the head of maybe a brother or sister or mom or dad. Ever tried doing that? No. The Bible tells us that God knows exactly how many hairs are on my head. And when one falls out, guess what? God knows it. And when one grows, God knows that too. But see, it's not just true with me. It's true with every one of you as well. You think that's a tough job? Yeah, I guess so. But God cares that much about us. And I think about how, if somebody cares enough about me to know how many hairs are in my head, they used to be very brown, they're now kind of all gray, but God knows that. And I think that if God knows that much about me, whoa, God must care a lot about me. See, God knows everything about me. God, when I'm really, 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 really good, guess what? Yeah, God knows that. And at times when I'm not as good as I'd like to be, yeah, see, God knows that too. Because God knows everything. And God knows everything because God cares about us. And God loves us. Let's pray. Lord, thank you. We sure can't figure out how you know all the number of hairs on our heads, but we are so glad that you do. We're so glad that you know us so well, that you care so very, very much about us, and that you love us so very, very much that you know everything about us. Thanks for that, Lord. Thank you. Watch over these children. Care for them and keep them safe. We ask all of this in the name of Jesus. Amen. On over for a treat. You guys have a great week. Thank you for coming. Good morning. Here we go. Olivia, good. Good morning. You're welcome, Jayla. Good morning. Hey, Nick. Good morning. Oh.
I have another sister.
Got one for your sister? Okay. Make sure your sister gets it. Good. Good morning. How are you, Lucy? Here we go. Good morning. Hi. Good morning. Good morning. Hi. Good morning. How are you today? Good, good, good. Good morning, Michael. Whoops. Here we go, Michael. Hi. Good morning. How are you today? Hi. They can be, can't they? But we love them anyways. Yes. Good morning. Oh, yes, brothers.
Joy, 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 happy joy.
To take this opportunity to thank the Woods and the Brass for playing for us. Kathy, Jean, David, George, and Tom Sanchez on bass trombone. Thank you, you guys.
This morning's scripture reading comes from the New Testament book of Galatians, the 6th chapter, verses 7 through 10. The reading is found in the Bible in your seats on page 1015. This morning I will be reading from the modern paraphrased version called The Message. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked, for you reap whatever you sow. If you sow to your own flesh, you will reap corruption from the flesh. But if you sow to the Spirit, you will reap eternal life from the Spirit. So let us not grow weary in doing what is right, for we will reap at harvest time if we do not give up. So then, whenever we have an opportunity, let us work for the good of all, and especially for those of the family of faith. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Our next hymn is number 89, Joyful, Joyful, hymn number 89.
Melt the
Please be seated. Let us pray. Lord, for the gift of this day and the gift of this message, we give you thanks, as it's my hope that you might use me, that your message might be brought forth this day. I pray for your blessing, your inspiration, and your strength. In the name of Christ, we pray. Amen. Well, it seems like last month we began this series. Oh, wait, it was. We've been following the Donovan family for the last 5 weeks. Remembering back 5 weeks ago when Frank and Cassie were hosting a welcome home celebration for a missionary family, and it was Frank and Cassie's young son that gave the vintage biplane his prized toy. He gave them to the missionary son who had no toys. And how that really began Frank's journey, his process, as it seemed to prick him and wake him up to realize that maybe what he was thinking was important really wasn't all that important. Then the second week, we remember how Frank had a dream, or maybe we should say a nightmare. It was pretty brutal. As Frank was on trial for loving his money more than he loved God, we remember seeing his 90%, the big belly, remember him. And Frank's generosity was not quite as big as Frank would have liked it to have been. The third week, we saw Frank and his daughter Megan at the soup kitchen. And Frank was very protective, wasn't he? He wanted to keep Megan safe. But Megan, she wanted to go help serve. So she goes running off and grabs a ladle and begins serving people. And then last Sunday, we saw Frank's wife, Cassie, being mugged as she was working at the soup kitchen. We're not sure if she was on her way there, if she had arrived there, if she was leaving her house. We don't know the details. All we know is that she was injured, and the doctors were concerned about a subdural hematoma, which is swelling of the brain. And Frank was convinced that all of his money was going to make a difference. He thought that he could snap his fingers and the surgeon would drop everything and let him see his wife. But that was not to be the case. And then we saw today's video. I'm trying to think back as to what would have been, for Frank, the real turning point. And I think we can probably pick and choose several over the last 5 Sundays as we have watched the videos. This morning I would lift up the notion that what we have is all God's to begin with, as probably the main thing that got Frank thinking very differently. When Frank realized that all he has is God's to begin with, and that there was very little he did in the process. Now, this is not to say that Frank was not a good manager of his money. We've known right from the get-go that Frank was concerned. He wanted to protect his family. That's why he met with Alan on day one. He met with his financial advisor to make sure his family would be protected and cared for with college, retirement, and yada, yada, yada. So Frank was a planner. I think about Friday, Veterans Day, and again, all that my dad gave to me. And there were some financial things, very little. And I think about President-elect Trump. And yeah, granted, he's probably one of the best walking definitions of arrogance. And I think even those that love him would agree that that's probably the case. But he's talked about this loan that he received from his father, $1 million. And he attributes that to getting everything going. So even President-elect Trump is not the self-made billionaire that many would think he is. And I think he gets that. Many of you have been told, and I've shared this before, that back 60-plus years ago, a couple people named Bob and Marge Van Wee went to the hospital when I was 4 days old and adopted me. And I have struggled with that for 60-plus years. And the struggle has been, who would I be today had it not been for those two people? I mean, the path that they set me on is not something I want to change, nor is it something I can change. But they brought me home from the hospital, and they raised me. Did they make mistakes? Oh, yeah. A lot of mistakes? Oh, no. But some mistakes, as we all do as parents. But they wanted what was best for me. And I think to myself, at times when I think, yeah, I obtained an associate's degree, the very first one in my family, in my generation. Wow, I am good. Then I remember who paid most of those bills from Mohawk Valley Community College. It was my mom and dad. At times I was working two part-time jobs, and mom was the one that would get me coffee in the morning to get me up and get me going. And I think about my bachelor's degree and my master's degree. And at times I get feeling pretty good about myself, thinking, look at me. And then I think about my mom and dad and all that they did for me. And then I realize how my life could have been so very, very different. So I get it. When Frank realizes that nothing is his, I realize that nothing that I have is really mine. It's all been given to me by someone or something, all been blessings from God. And it's what I then do with those blessings is my gift back to God. And that's always the challenge. It's always a challenge to realize that, yeah, there are a few things I have done in my life that I can stand up and say, I did that. I'm proud of that. But there's so much that's just a blessing and gift from my parents, a blessing and a gift from Almighty God. When we think about our Living Generously series we've looked at over the last 5 weeks, probably for Frank Donovan, the turning point was when he realized that all of his money, it really wasn't his to begin with. And this point today he made was, sure, if we lose something, it's just a matter of God taking it from one pocket and putting it in another pocket, because it's all God's to begin with. You'll see on the financial cards that Paul and Barbara talked about this morning, there's a place in there for your financial commitment, and that's important. Yes, I don't want to downplay that. That's important stuff. It helps us plan for finances for next year. But beyond that, we also look at the time we have. Because while we may not have the same financial resources, we all have exactly 60 seconds in 1 minute, 60 minutes in 1 hour, 24 hours in 1 day, 7 days in 1 week. You get it. We all have the same. What are you going to do with those minutes and seconds and hours and days? Because we all have the same gift from God, same amount of time. Some of us have a variety of different gifts. How do we use those gifts as a way of saying thank you to God? So that's our challenge this day and this week. The chorus of reflection is one of my favorites. It typically wakes me in the morning, sung by Elvis Presley of all people. And thinking of his life, which seemed to be going oh so well, but obviously we know his turmoils, his frustrations, and his tensions in life. When our life is being tossed to and fro, stand by me, stand by me. Sing with me, please, the chorus of reflection.
In the midst of tribulation, stand by me.
This past Wednesday at our finance committee meeting, we were discussing Christmas Eve and the Christmas offering that Asbury receives. And the finance committee decided, and I wholeheartedly agree, that this year we will be tithing our Christmas offering and giving it to the mission committee to do with as they choose. It is I think a bold and courageous move on the part of our church, as typically towards the end of the year, every penny counts. But we also know that mission's important and that God's blessed us with everything we have. And to give 10% to other people, I think it's biblical. I think it's about that tithe thing, giving away 10%. So Deb, that's the news. Awesome. I thought you might like that. Have you turned this morning to our prayers, which you'll find listed in the bulletin on page 8. At the very top, there's a number of United Methodist concerns. There's our deployed troops. At the bottom, there's a number of family members and friends who are hurting and those who are celebrating this week. In addition, we also lift up the family of Michael Fedora. Michael passed away on Friday. We also give thanks that Rick Lacey's in town, helping Rita get moved into Summit. And Rick, welcome. And also this morning, we lift up the family of Michael Webster, who passed away a couple weeks ago. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, for the gift of the church as a place where we can gather to worship, we are grateful. For we bring to church our hopes and dreams. We bring to church our plans, our expectations. And we pray that your hand will guide us and lead us. We also bring to worship our hurts and frustrations and disappointments. We bring to worship our grief. And we lay it all before you. And as you pick us up and move us into the future, we're so grateful. For time to lift our voices in prayer and in praise, we give you thanks. This day, gracious God, we lift up our nation, praying that you will lead us into where you want us to go. Help us to see your will and your way for us. We lift up our leaders, the newly elected leaders, those currently serving, those who are not successful in their campaigns. We lift them up and give you thanks for them. Help us, Lord, to work together. Help us to move into your future, the future that you are calling us into. We ask for your guiding hand to be upon us. And we give you thanks. And now we offer this prayer in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray and say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Meredith. Thank you all for supporting my Pancakes for Peace mission trip to Nicaragua. I appreciate it very much, and thank you. I know that Meredith is extremely pleased for all the support that Asbury has provided over the last several months. God's given to us, we now give to God. Ushers will receive our morning offering. Lord, everything is yours. Everything is yours. So we give back to you a part of what you've given to us, with a hope and prayer that you might multiply it and use it to build your kingdom, to share the good news of Jesus, to reach out and feed the hungry, comfort the afflicted. Lord, we dedicate these gifts to your glory this day, doing it all in the name of Jesus. Amen. Our closing hymn is number 569. We have a story to tell to the nations, 569. Please be seated. Throughout the years, God's people have felt that we have a story. We have a story that no other organization has. It's a story we need to share. And sometimes we do that through our singing, and sometimes we do that through our talking, and sometimes we do that through our actions. It's all about telling that story any way and shape and form that we can. That's our challenge today, to tell the story. Kathy? Reminder that Darlene, our faith community nurse, will be taking blood pressures after worship in the parlor. Our children's choir will be gathering down front soon to begin practice. Also, our Sunday school will be viewing a movie in about 20 minutes in Wesley Hall. And the rest of us, we can go out and be God's people to God's world. But first, stop and have some refreshments. God's brought us here. God now sends us forth. Thanks be to God. Amen.
This has been a broadcast of the 10:15 service, Sunday morning, from Asbury United Methodist Church, located on Franklin Street in Watertown. Asbury United Methodist Church.